So, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the latest webinar from Rocket Root, Spotlight on New Features. I can see we still have a couple of people joining, so we'll just give everyone 30 seconds or so just to get online and sort out their audio, and then we'll get started. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as I said, very warm welcome to this next webinar in the series of Spotlight On. This one is on new features by Rocket Root. Just before we get started, you're all muted, but that doesn't mean to say you can't interact with us. There is a ability for you to ask questions. So on the right hand side of the screen, you will see a little question pop up. If you click on that, you can ask any questions in there. We do have a team of staff that are reviewing the questions, and they will be feeding those into us during the presentation. We will try to answer some of those questions at the end. Unfortunately, we may not have time to feed in all of the questions that we'd like to do, but please rest assured you will get a response either via your BDM account manager or one of the Rocket Root team after the presentation has been completed. So moving on, just about today's presenter. So my name is Stephen Morgan. I'm the business development manager for Rocket Root. I've been with the company for 6.5 years, and prior to that I worked for Jeppesen. My background is in aviation, having worked for two commercial airlines prior to working for Jeppesen. Moving on to today's agenda, we will cover a variety of features and improvements on our web and mobile applications. Rocket Root is proud that we are actively supporting both Android and iOS platforms, and we will show you the improvements on those sites. On our website, we will show the next flight multi-sector briefing pack, templates and template validity, route advisories, the update to step 2 and the crew selection, also the new information tab, NAT, OTS and messages, and also the alternate selection. And then on the mobile side, we'll be talking about georeference charts, the visual route editor and upload document functions. So the first item we're going to be covering today is the next flight. We will be speeding up the process of creating a group of flights. Relevant data is going to roll from one flight automatically into the next. We automatically have built in a 30-minute turnaround built on the next flight to expected off-blocks time, and landing fuel from the previous flight used as the initial flight for the next one. So how do we create this? As you can see here, we've got a flight on here on the all flights page, and going to the next flight page, we would be able to click on that using the three dots. Click on the next flight, and you can see here it's pulled in the information from the last flight. So this flight previously would have landed into LFMN, which is Nice, and we've also added automatically 30 minutes onto the expected time of arrival from the last landing flight. The fuel scenario at this point will now change to a manual fuel scenario, and the landing fuel that you would have arrived into Nice is now carried over as the initial starting fuel for the next sector. That is shown here, as you can see here, flight 1 from Hamburg down to Nice arrives with 8,180 pounds of fuel. Then the initial fuel that is calculated for the next sector is also going to then be 8,180. So this then leads into our next new feature, which is the multi-sector briefing. We then allow up to 5 sectors to be merged into a single briefing pack. We then do some deduplication of NOTAMs and weather reports, meaning there's a smaller pack for the crews to review. And then there's also, again, some efficiency savings that you don't have to have several different copies of of airport briefings as you're going in and out of them, potentially if you're going into a hub airport on two or three occasions. Like before, on the all flights list, you select the two flights that you'd want to put into the briefing pack. There is two tick boxes that are there. Select those two flights, and then a new option will appear at the top, which is for the multi-sector briefing pack. From here, the system will then create the multi-sector briefing pack, and then the relevant flight data will be put together. As you can see from this video, you'll see the front page for the first flight, along with the OFP, and then the mass and balance, and then the route map, and then that will repeat for all remaining flights. After that, we'll follow the NOTAM report and all of the weather reports as well. On to another useful function that we have, and an improvement that we have as well. We have our templates functionality and templates validity. This is a great feature for saving time with all the required information. It's a step on for having having your company preferred routes. This is great for use case where you have regular flights between two airports with similar parameters, or if you've got complex ad hoc routes that you want to have saved. For instance, if you have maintenance flights and you have many different items in field 18. We also have now a new functionality to maintain valid flight plans ready for filing at a drop of a hat. So let's run through the templates functionality. On the templates functionality, it can be found by going to the drop down and finding templates. You can create a new template by clicking on the new button. You can then, once you have one set up, you can use it by clicking on the use button. You can copy it and make adjustments to it by using the copy button. And if you just want to edit your original template, you can click on the edit button. Of course, if you want to delete it, you can click the red dustbin and it will be removed from your list. You can see here when opening a new template, it looks exactly like our step one in the process that we have currently. The only difference, you have a template name at the top where you can assign the name of the template, which is what you'll use to recall this in future. As you can see here, we've created this template, which is showing a flight from Farnborough to Teterboro. And all the steps can be pre-filled. So this is a great way to have all of the alternates prepared, any of the en route alternates, especially for doing an EDTO flight. If you have certain field remarks, etc., also saved, these can also be pre-filled in these templates. As I said, for non-standard flights and for our military and HEMS customers, this is a great tool for being able to have all of this pre-prepared and pre-planned ready to go. To use them, very simple, just click the use button after going into the templates tab. And now we have our new feature, which is going to be maintain. And this is where you will be able to set a schedule for your flights. So particularly if you're running a scheduled operation, this is where the templates will be automatically maintained and looked after, revalidating at regular intervals, checking for the validity of that route. If one happens to suddenly become invalid due to a change in the RAD or any other condition, the system will then automatically go to look for a new auto route. As you can see here with the status, anything that's green is valid and could be filed. Anything that is in yellow is currently going through a revalidation process and is searching for a new route if not available. And a red one is showing that there's an invalid route. In the event of an invalid route, the system will try to re-auto route on three occasions. If this indeed comes up with a further error, an email notification is sent to yourself. This is a function, the templates function is something for a business level account. And if this is something that you are interested in, please do contact the Rocket Root sales team, who will be happy to provide you with a trial account on that level. On to another improvement within Rocket Root and our root advisories. This is now able to be contained within the briefing pack, which it previously wasn't. Also, it was in a pop-up, which was causing an interruption within the workflow. We've also provided an improvement to this with airport and runway closures via NOTAM now being included in the advisories. This can be found on the filing page, on the yellow strap underneath the route information. It can also be found on the main information page to do with your flight plan. And to see the information, simply click the view button. The route advisory panel then will open. You'll see what route advisories have been provided. Many of these have been provided by our own 24/7 operations team, who provides information and support to our customers as required. Where necessary, we've put in pertinent information to your flight to help you with all aspects of it, whether that be a PPR requirement, if it's a notification that the airport that you're planning into may be a military airfield that you weren't aware of. The example shown here also shows that my alternate happens to be closed at this current time. We give you some information regarding that and also our hyperlink to the NOTAM. By clicking on that hyperlink, we will open our NOTAM briefing so you can see further information in regards to that closure. As mentioned previously, this is now available as an option in the briefing pack to the pilots. They're able to review all of the same route advisories as the dispatcher would have done as well. Moving on to our next improvement, and it's something that went live earlier this week, was the removal of step two and the migration of the crew selection into step one. This is further streamlining the process, improving the efficiency of Rocket Root, reducing the number of clicks and the number of page loading time, enabling you to complete your flight planning process as quickly and as efficiently as possible. We have a next improvement about to roll into the implementation of this, with the selection of cabin crew and passengers also be enabled to be selected on step one. A further improvement onto this is the change process for an already filed flight plan. This will also be on a single screen. As you can see here on the left-hand side is showing a flight from last week where this was not available and we had the three-step process. And on the right-hand side, we have the new process where the crew selection and the search and rescue is now moved into step one. The crew selection can now be found on step one. In this case, on a business level account below the EDTO setting. If you do not have this level of accounts, it will fit underneath the fuel and mass and balance. The previous search and rescue items is now below field 18 and the field 19 section, and all laid out exactly how you'd require it. I'll just thank you already for the questions that are coming in, and we look forward to having some responses to those at the end of the call. The next new feature that I'd like to be able to show you today is the new information tab. This allows quick and easy access to the flight log and mass and balance information. We have a future implementation plan, which includes the vertical profile, NOTAMs, and also a risk assessment in cooperation with Osprey Flight Solutions. In this, we have the ability to zoom in and out of relevant information, and if you require it, open this in a new browser tab as well. As you'll see here on the top right-hand side, there is a small tab for being able to open the information. The flight log is shown here, and then you can able to zoom in to the relevant sections for you to check the items that you would need to during the planning process. You can also review any part of the OFP and also the route to alternate. At this point, you can also then look at the mass and balance and zoom in to see the relevant information. If making changes on the left-hand side, the page will refresh and be available with the new figures that have been entered in on the right-hand side. As mentioned, the next improvement will include the vertical profile terrain awareness panel. This first iteration, once released, will include terrain, route for both the main and alternate routes, MEA data, airports, FIRs, the chopper pause, and if you're operating a single engine turbine, will also depict the glide cone. Further iterations after release will include wind barbs, icing, and turbulence. Here I've planned a flight with a PC-12 aircraft using the setups function. As you can see, on the right-hand side is our new vertical terrain. You can see here that the green sections are both the SID and the STAR, and then the magenta line is showing the main route. At the bottom, you will see the terrain that the aircraft is passing over directly. And you can also see a number of landing sites that have been specified by the operator. Now, what you will see is some of the landing sites don't match up exactly with the terrain, but that's obviously because they are offset from the main route of flight. But looking at the overhead, you can see that they are within the glide circle. So if you are a single engine turbine operator, this is a great extra feature for you to be able to review whether or not you're going to be kept safe or not during your flight. As you can see at the top, you can see the FIRs that the aircraft is passing through. And the scale is also showing the altitude of the flight during it. You also have a distance running along the bottom. And you can also, on this panel, as before, zoom in to see relevant information. If you wanted to get a better picture of this, you can also open it in a browser, and then the full panel would be available to be shown. The green dotted line shows the MEA, and if the aircraft was flying higher, then the chopper pause would also be shown as well. This page is also going to be available within the pilot briefing pack as well as we roll through the iterations and the implementation plan. The next improvement that we have within Rocket Routes and the new function is the NAT OTS, so that's the Organized Track System Visualization, and also the track message as well. You can easily now view the position of the NAT OTS, and you can also see the track message within the user interface. The track message is now automatically added to the briefing pack if flying in the NAT HLA, so the high level area, or above. To show how this is enabled, you can go to the settings on the right-hand side of the page and click either the westbound or eastbound OTS. Then to view the track, click on the OTS route, and you can see that here. Another small but great improvement is the alternate selection. Alternate options are now provided closest to the point of arrival. We do have some filtering that jet aircraft are shown all IFR airfield options. Turboprops and piston aircraft are shown all airfields except helipads, and helicopters are shown all available options. We have a further improvement coming, which will allow the filtering based on runway length. Therefore, those operators with larger aircraft can filter the results based on their requirements. Just to give you an example, this is the same airfield and looking for alternates. On the left-hand side, you will see what a jet operator will see. And on the right-hand side is what a helicopter operator will see. So the next section of the call today is going to go on to the Rocket Route mobile highlights. This is made up of 3 points: the visual route editor, We'll run through some of those root elements, giving graphical structures, some quick adjustment of the roots, and also the easy addition of stay information. We also have a georeferenced approach plates update to show you, and also the upload document option as well. So how you can make any document you would like to be part of your briefing pack. The visual root editor is an adjustment to our mobile platforms. The flight plan root string is now interactive. A user can tap anywhere on the section of the route and be able to receive some context information. This update is really useful and powerful for VFR flight plan creation and new routes. You can add new waypoints from the list as well. On the right-hand side of the screen, you can get some examples of this, and we're going to continue through with some of those specific examples in the next few slides. You can see here we have a color coding of the objects within the visual route editor. Yellow ones are either airways or DCT sectors, so the direct segments. Black are waypoints or coordinates. Green items are VFR airports, and blue are IFR airports or SID and STAR indicators. If any of them are an error, they'll be shown in red. We now have the ability to insert afterwards, so you can click on an item and then a pop-up appears with the option to insert after. Here you can insert a waypoint, en route airport, VRP, or user waypoint into the route string. In this example, you can add a waypoint and we will provide you with options based on a distance from that initial waypoint. You can also do it by tapping on the map, by clicking on the map icon, and then clicking on the selected waypoint on the map. If you wanted to move an existing waypoint in a flight plan, this is very similar to the drag and drop in the website application. You have two options. You can either tap on the submenu, or you can highlight it with a tap on the map. If you're doing that, you can click the move. It will then highlight, and then you can move to the waypoint that you wish to adjust it to. And in this case, moving to Rabid, and you can see here the route string will also update as a result. If you wanted to make a change in speed or altitude, again, this can be easily completed. Tap on the waypoint, select the speed or altitude change, write in the new speed or value, and then just click apply. We now have georeference charts available. We currently have these available for the United States, and we plan to have rollout of this for other regions in the world as we progress throughout the year. If you have any specific requirements around this, please do not hesitate to contact us, and we'll be happy to look at your requirements regarding this. Another great update, which was released last week, is the upload documents function on the mobile applications. This has been a useful feature for many years on the website. We have now got to this on the mobile site. It allows our users to add documents as required. Simply snap a photograph or upload the document and the briefing pack will update. Operations can see the documentation that's been added in near real time as it's automatically added to the cloud and also to the briefing pack. If it's added to the briefing pack and you're on a business account, this will automatically be backed up for a 5-year period for auditing purposes. That makes taking the photo of a fuel release or receipt a valuable item that can be then audited in real time. This is now available on both iOS and Android platforms. What you can see now is the iOS platform. And now you can see how this looks on the Android platform. So I will thank you for the questions that have come in, and my colleagues have been updating this with those questions, so we'll be getting through those in a moment. If you don't have a current Rocketroot account, you can just easily sign up at rocketroot.com/login/signup. If you want to contact us directly or at the sales team, it's sales@rocketroot.com. And a lot of these items have some blog articles, and they can be found at rocketroot.com/blog. There's some useful information, often written by our operations team as well. So there's also hints and tips about best ways to perform. You'll also see if we're going to events or other webinars where they will be shown. So just going to some of those questions that have come in already. The first one, are the features available in all subscriptions? Not all of them are available in all of the subscriptions. In this case, the templates function is not available in all the business subscriptions. If you have questions around any of them specifically, do contact your account manager or send an email to sales@rocketroot.com, and they'll be happy to support you with your questions. Question two, will a copy of this webinar be available? Yes, it will be. You'll receive a recording of the link of this event in your email in the next few days. When will the vertical profile be available? That's a very good question. We hope to have that available next week. We're going through the last few phases of quality assurance testing with our teams. Question four, can you arrange a follow-up call to go through this in more detail? Of course. Contact sales@rocketroot.com or contact your account manager if you know them. A personalised demo could be arranged, and in some cases we can deal with you in local language. We have a number of local language speakers. We have French. We have several Scandinavian languages, so Finnish, Swedish. We also have Spanish, Portuguese, and also Russian as well is available. Will we have a session to demo a full flight? Yes, we do have that. We have a webinar on the Wednesday, the 20th of May, to show all the basics of flight planning within Rocketroot. So if you're new to Rocketroot or would just like a refresher course, please do attend that on the 20th. Can you tell us anything about new that you're working on? Well, yes, hopefully I've showed you some of those releases in this call. We have lots of releases coming all the time. Stay tuned for some of those as they're coming up. One big thing is to make sure that your Rocketroot app is always updated, and also make sure that you're signed up for our newsletter. You can also follow us on Twitter, LinkedIn, and also on Facebook, where there's many updates and notifications about new features. And also, as I mentioned on the previous slide, about the blog page as well. Another question, I currently do not have an account, but my aircraft is currently grounded. Can I still try these? Yes, of course. So just sign up for a free trial at rocketroot.com. Again, if you have any questions, you can deal with those. And I think that's all the questions we've had so far. And I again apologize if we haven't been able to get through yours in time, but we will respond to you directly after this call. Some further upcoming webinars. So next week we have a spotlight on our Rocketroot flight board. So that's a great product for fleet tracking and looking at movements of aircraft through airports. It's a very useful function. I will be doing that one along with a colleague of mine next week, so I hope you can attend that one. And then, as mentioned earlier, we have the introduction to flight planning on Wednesday the 20th, and that just to make sure that's a Wednesday the 20th, so in just under 2 weeks' time. In June, we're also planning some in-depth webinars, and some of them on individual features in what's going to be called the Under the Hood series. This will be communicated in due course, but should you have a specific topic you'd like us to cover, let us know, and we'll look to have that as part of that series. So please do let us know. So just to thank you for your time today. At the cessation of this webinar, there is going to be a survey appearing. It would be great to have your feedback on that. There's also an opportunity for you to ask any further questions that you may have from today's webinar. So from myself and the rest of the Rocket Route team, I just want to thank you for your time today, also for your custom through this very difficult period. And we hope that we can assist you in any way that we can. And we hope that in the next few weeks and months that we'll be back to normal. Thank you again, and I wish you all a great day. Goodbye.